Here's a funny story from the writers of university exams. A physics professor runs a course on air pressure. The course is about modeling atmospheric changes in pressure due to winds and upper atmosphere. The final exam is an oral exam, and to his first student, he asks, "If we were both standing on the top of a very tall building, if I gave you a barometer, how would you measure the height of the building?" Now to the professor, the answer is obvious. A barometer measures the pressure. The higher up in the atmosphere you go, the lower the pressure becomes, eventually reaching zero once you reach space. All the student has to do is know the equation for atmospheric pressure as a function from sea level. The student ponders. The student thinks. "So professor, what I would do is I would pick up the barometer, I would walk to the edge of the building, and I would drop it off the side. If this building is as tall as you say it is, then the barometer is going to be traveling at mostly terminal velocity. If I know this terminal velocity, I can time how long it is for it to hit the ground and get the height of the building that way." The professor strokes the bridge of his nose slightly. Okay. Let me rephrase the question. Without letting go of the barometer, how could we measure the height of the building? The student then goes, "Well, professor, my arm is about 1 meter, right?" "Right. Well, if I let my arm go limp and dangle it so that the barometer acts like a pendulum, then if I know the center of mass of my arm and barometer system from the period of the pendulum, I know gravitational acceleration. And if this building is as tall as you say, professor, then the gravitational acceleration should be weaker than at sea level. Knowing that gravitational strength weakens by the distance to the center of the Earth squared, I can get the height of the building." The professor then says, "Right, I am grabbing the barometer out of your hands. I am putting super glue on the side and I'm sticking it on the ground there on the roof of the building. You are not allowed to touch it just from looking and observing at the barometer. How can you figure out the height of the building? Go." The student thinks and thinks and thinks. "As long as I don't touch the barometer, I can do anything I want, right?" The professor cleans the bridge of his nose and goes, "Yes, as long as you're using the barometer and you're not throwing it, you're not dangling it, your answer will work." The student then goes, "Okay, so we're still at the edge of the building, right? Well, if the barometer is planted at the edge of the building, I will wait until the shadow of the barometer just barely goes over the edge of the building. Because the top of the building is flat, then its ratio with the ratio of the building's shadow should be the same. But if this building is as tall as you say it is, Professor, then the curvature of the Earth will elongate the building's shadow considerably. By measuring the extra length of the shadow and comparing that, it is possible to calculate the ratio of the building's height to the radius of the Earth. That, Professor, is how I will get the height of the building." The professor then pushes the student off. In the first year of university, this was the story that my professor used to explain the difference between university and high school physics. If you're doing A-levels or AP, then physics has a clear mark scheme, it has a clear syllabus, it has a clear list of things you need to know, and each question very clearly draws on one of these things to build your answer. However, at university, there is usually no mark scheme, or at least, there is no singular mark scheme. If your approach is correct, and the professor did not make it clear you needed to use a specific method, then in practice, you should get the mark. University physics is hard, but there's a reason why I still love it. Because it's where you start to treat physics like a tool. You're no longer learning topics to answer a set of questions. you are combining them together, working towards the ultimate puzzle game that is the universe. This is an unusual April Fool's video. I just wanted to share this funny story. I hope you had a good time. Have a good evening.